reggae musician, and he said some beautiful words about women. And some of those words were like, in the middle of the night, I heard her pray so bitterly and so softly. She prayed for her children. She prayed for their education. And then she prayed for the men that left her with those children. We praise heroes every day, but there are those that we forget to praise. And they are the women of this world. Because they do not complain about anything. They just stand up and fight. They do not complain about the financial difficulties. They just stand up and protect. They do not complain about all the men that do them evil. They just stand up and fight for their children. So God bless the women. Especially in Nigeria, if you haven't heard about the 270 some school girls under the age of 18 who were abducted, kidnapped in Nigeria and taken away from their families for almost a month now, I hope you go and search about it. If you see those anything about that on Facebook or on any social media, please share it, spread the message. The mainstream media have ignored that story for almost 3 weeks before they picked up on it. And the reason they picked it up on it was because the social media was spreading it. So the voice of the people is the voice of God. So we have to raise our voices. Now this is for the generation born without a choice. Born more broke than broke, more poor than poor, this one wants the world to hear their voices. Because there are so many nowadays claiming hardship because they were born in the city with a family full of love. And yet, the real poverty is known that just because you make minimum wage doesn't make you poor. See, there is a difference between making minimum wage and being poor. There is a difference between financial problem and dead broke with nothing to live for. When the minimum wage wear Pumas and Adidas, they make funny of the poor for walking barefooted and call them broke. See, the minimum wage can take a bite out of a full course meal and throw the rest away, but the poor eat rice and beans and eggs and put ketchup on top and call that gourmet. So next time you laugh at a homeless standing on a corner, remember that who make who you are, the reason why you sleep. Next time you see a young man trying to get a job, hook the brother up, help him up, because that's the reason why he never made up. Never forget the grip, the grind, the hard time, the poor. Always remember the poor people, even though it makes your heart hurt. Remember the poor people. And I'm not trying to tell you how to live, but vanity will kill you. And so will Fox News. Now remember in the past how you got blessed. Remember that same God who blessed you always have a pocket full of Generation Next. Next up to Oprah. Next up to Bill Gates. Next up to all of you that are here and being blessed and living under his comfort. So believe me when I tell you, your money is not the root of all evil. Because you will see pure hell coming when you forget about the poor people. my mother. Black woman, African woman. To you, my mother, I think of you. Oh, the mom, oh, my mother. It's you that carried me on the back. It's you that nursed me. It's you that governed my first steps here on earth. I think of you. It's you. It's you that opened my eyes to the beauties of the world. I think of you. Woman of the field, woman of the rivers, woman of the great, great rivers. To you, my mother, I think of you. Oh, the mom, oh, my mother. It's you that wiped off my tears. It's you that cheered up my heart. It's you that patiently dealt with my caprices. How I'd love to still be near you. Simple woman, woman of resilience. Oh, mother, I think of you. Oh, the mom of the great family of the blacksmith. My thoughts are always with me. They accompany me with every step. Oh, the mom, oh, my mother, how I'd love to still be near you, to still feel your warmth, to be your child. Black woman, African woman, oh, mother, thank you. Thank you for all that you've done for me. Your son, so far away and yet so close to you. Oh, mother, I think of you.